Hello students, today you will see a small problem relating to how to calculate the average rate of reaction. Okay, so the problem is, see, in the decomposition of N2O5, that is, you are given an equation, a balanced equation, that is 2N2O5 gives 4NO2 plus O2. Calculate the average rate of reaction and rate of production of N2O2. So what we have asked to find out is the average rate of reaction. Okay, for that it is given the initial concentration of N2O5 as 2.33 mole per liter and final concentration of N2O5 is 2.08 mole per liter. So the concentration, initial concentration as well as the final concentration is given. And also in time is given as 184 minutes. So time is given in minutes. Yesterday when we talked about the unit of rate of reaction, we found it in moles per liter per second. Okay, so only if the question demands, you convert this minute into second. Otherwise, if you want to keep in minutes, that is okay, well and good. Okay, but if the question demands that you convert this minute into second, you have to convert that minute into second. That's all. Okay, so in this problem, we will keep it like that, in minutes only. Okay, so how will you calculate the average rate of reaction? First, we will write how to calculate the average rate of reaction. Okay, that is, you can write, this is 2N2O5, so I can write minus 1 by 2 into delta of concentration of N2O5 divided by delta T. Am I right? Yesterday we talked about this, that is, you have to divide it by the stoichiometric coefficient. Correct. So that is equal to, how I can write? That is equal to 4NO2 plus O2, that is plus 1 by 4 into then concentration of NO2 divided by concentration delta T. That is again equal to plus, that is the stoichiometric coefficient is 1. So I can write 1 by 1. If it is not also, it is okay. That is delta of concentration of O2 by delta T. So this is how you write the average rate of reaction. Is it correct? Now what they said, they have given you the initial and the final concentration of the N2O5. So you can find the delta N2O5 of this, isn't it? Correct? You are getting it? This delta is what? Delta means R2 minus R1. Yesterday we talked about R2 minus R1 by T2 minus T1. Isn't it? So, I can write this as, that is equal to delta, so average rate. Okay. So, if I say average rate of reaction, that is average R of R is equal to minus 1 by 2 into, how will I go for delta N2O5? What is R2? What is final? That is 2.08 minus 2.33. Correct? See, this is final. See, the final concentration of N2O5. That is 2.08. So, it is 2.08 minus, what is the initial concentration? 2.33 mole per liter. So, it will become 2.08 minus 2.33. If you want, you can write mole per liter divided by, what is delta T? T2 minus T1. That is, T1 is what? 0. Because it is from the starting. So, T1 you can take it as 0. And T2 is 184 minutes. So, I can write T2 minus T1 is 184 minus 0. That will become 184. Correct? So, if you want to write minutes. Okay. So, on calculating this, we will get, see, here there is a minus. Here how you calculate 2.08 minus 2.33. You will get, this is lower and this is higher, this thing. So, from my, you will get a minus here. Correct? So, on calculating, this minus and minus will become plus. That is why in the last class I told you the rate of reaction will always be positive. Okay, so this is how it happens. Understood? That means final minus initial, final will be lesser quantity. Why? As the time is getting consumed, the rate of reaction, I mean the concentration of the reactant is getting decreased. So the value will be decreased there. So a lesser value minus a higher value, because initially it is higher value. So that will become a minus. And you already know that the rate of disappearance is again minus. So that minus and minus will come to plus. So that is why in the last class we talked about the rate of reaction will be always positive. Correct. Now on calculating this, you will get a value as like 6.79 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per minute. Let's do the calculation. Okay. So this is how you calculate the average rate of reaction. Now why you took this 1 by 2 of delta N2, N2O5 and delta T? Because in this numerical you would have given the initial concentration of N2O5 and the final concentration of N2O5. Suppose if you are given the concentration of NO2 rather than N2O5, so in which formula you will substitute? You will substitute in this formula, that is plus 1 by 4 into delta NO2 and delta. Here you will get a positive because product is increasing, isn't it? So that is the difference. So now I think you got the point. Okay, so you got it as the average rate of reaction. The first part is okay. That is, the average rate of reaction is equal to 6.79 in 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per minute. Okay, so if you want to convert in second, you can have in second divided by 60. Or if you want to convert, for example, if the question asks, convert this into hour. So you can convert it into hour or in second. Or nothing is asked, the question demands nothing. Like whatever, if it is in minutes, you can have minutes, no problem. Okay, so that's all. So this is how you calculate the average rate of reaction. Clear? Now the second point, I mean the second question is, how will you calculate the rate of production of NO2? See, what is the rate of production of NO2? What it implies? From the equation, it will be a well-balanced equation. From the equation, you know that the production means rate of appearance of NO2. See? Isn't it? The rate of production of NO2 means the rate of appearance. Last class, we have talked about the rate of disappearance. From this equation, you can say the rate of disappearance of N2O5 and the rate of appearance of NO2 and O2. So, rate of production means they are asking you what is the rate of appearance of NO2. So, how will you calculate the rate of appearance of NO2? How will you calculate? This is okay? Now, we will see how to calculate the rate of production of NO2. Now, we know the rate of production from the rate of reaction, we know plus 1 by 4 into delta of concentration of NO2 by delta T is equal to the rate of reaction. Correct? Isn't it? So, from the average rate of reaction, you know this formula. Isn't it? Now, we have calculated the rate of reaction from what? From this N2O5. Now, what was that? The rate of reaction comes as 6.79 into 10 to the power minus 4 mole per liter per minute. Isn't it? You got the value of rate of reaction indirectly from this N2O5, isn't it? As what? 6.79 10 to the power minus 4 mole, 10 to the power minus 4 mole per liter per minute. Now, this I am equating it into what? 1 by 4 into, because rate is equal to average rate of reaction. Or last class, what we define the rate of reaction? It is the changing concentration of any one of the species, any one of the reactant with respect to time, or any one of the product with respect to time. So you can equate it as this rate of reaction from this N2O5 is equal to 1 by 4 into plus 1 by 4 into the delta NO2 by delta T. what you have to calculate in this formula, I mean in the numerical, you have to calculate the rate of production of NO2. That means the rate of appearance of NO2. How much is appearing or how much NO2 is forming in this reaction. So, you have to calculate this delta NO2 by delta T. So, how will you calculate? Simple. Cross multiply. Isn't it? So, you can write delta concentration of NO2 divided by delta T is equal to cross multiply 4 into the rate of reaction. Correct? Isn't it? So, 4 into rate of reaction means 4 into 6.79 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per minute. So, this is how you calculate what? The rate of production of NO2. Or sometimes you can, they can ask rate of appearance or rate of disappearance. Okay. In any format they can ask, but you should have the concept with you. That's all. Okay. So, this numerical, the easy numerical board exam, they are asking these type of numericals. So, is it clear? Any doubt, please call me. I will get it for you. Okay. So, this is one numerical I want to check out. Now, we will pass on to the next simple topic. That is, in the last class we talked about, in this chemical kinetics, we are dealing with the three things. One is the rate of reaction that we have already studied. Next is what? The factors which affect the rate of reaction, isn't it? Now, what are the factors which affect the rate of reaction? I told about the concentration. Then second is a pressure. Third is a catalyst, etc. Nature of the reactant. So many factors are there. Out of which I told you there are two important factors. That is the concentration as well as the temperature. Now, today we will see a small portion of how or what is the effect of concentration in the rate of reaction. Okay, what is it? Today we will see the effect of concentration in the rate of reaction. So, what is the effect? What is the effect of concentration in the rate of the reaction? Now, I will tell you one thing. This rate of reaction which we are doing is an experimental quantity. Have you got it? This is an that is, by doing the experiment, we will get that rate of reaction. This is very, very important. Okay, so in the effect of concentration, by doing the experiment, listen very carefully, while doing the experiment, we have observed that the rate of reaction decreases with decrease in the concentration of reactants. I am talking about reactants. Correct? The rate of reaction depends on the concentration of the reactants. Correct? Now, if the concentration of the reactant decreases, experimentally it is proven that, I am underlining the experimentally, that means it is not a theoretical thing. It is all we are getting from the experiment. From the experiment you are proving. That is, the rate of reaction increases as the concentration increases, or conversely we can say always the reactants decreases, isn't it? So we can say as the concentration of the reactant decreases, the rate of the reaction is found to be decreasing. This is experimental. Okay, now I will just make a it more simple to understand this concept. That is very, very important. So, keep in mind what? This is an experimental quantity. This is not a theoretical quantity which has nothing to do with a balanced chemical equation. First, you have to keep in mind that. This is only what the experiment is proving that you have to write. That's all. Okay. Now, if I write a general formula or a hypothetical formula, for example, one more thing. This effect of concentration can be expressed in a rate law. What is it? Rate law. Now we will see what a rate law means. Okay. What is a rate law? After rate law, we will go to that explanation. Okay. Now it is very important. What is a rate law? Or a rate expression? In both ways, we can say what is a rate law or a rate expression. Now, this rate law means it is the dependence of the rate of reaction with the concentration of the species. Got it? Rate law is something which is the dependence of the rate of reaction to the concentration of the species, or you can specifically say concentration of reactants, any one of the reactants, or concentration of reactants. Product also you can say, but in a textbook we are dealing with the concentration of the reactants. So that's why I am saying that is the dependence of the rate of reaction with the concentration of the reactants. Clear? So what is rate law or rate expression means? It is the dependence of what? It is the dependence of the rate of reaction with the concentration of the reactants. See? Rate of reaction, I can say it is a small r. This small r, now onwards we will write small r for the rate of reaction. Okay. So the small r is dependent on the concentration of the reactants. Clear? So that is the rate law or the rate expression means. Okay, now we will see more about how you write a rate law in with respect to concentration of reactants. I already said it is both reactants as well as products, but in your textbook we are only dealing with the reactants. That's why I am specifically saying that the rate law is the dependence between the rate of reaction as well as the concentration of the reactants. Correct? Okay, now we will have an example for that. Okay, we will see an example related to the rate law or how you will write a rate law. Okay, so listen carefully. Just we will take a simple example. 2A plus B giving products. Okay, this is an example that is 2A plus B giving products. How you will write the rate of a reaction or a rate law? Now, experimentally proven. I always am saying again and again that the rate law or the rate expression can be determined only by one method, that is experiment. Keep in mind, always keep in mind, that is the rate law or the rate expression can be found only by one method, that is experimental. Nothing in connection with this balanced equation or the stoichiometry of the equation, nothing. Okay, just we will see how it goes. Okay, so if I take a reaction 2A plus B giving product, and if I say the rate of reaction, that is ROR or small r, listen, we are taking A, the keeping the concentration of B constant, that is there is no change in the concentration of B. If the concentration of A is doubled, listen carefully, what do you mean doubled? A becomes 2B. Okay, if the concentration of A is doubled, okay, if the concentration of A is doubled, experimentally you will get the rate of reaction is also doubled. See, listen very carefully, you have to get this concept. That means if this is just a situation which I am telling you, okay, that means if in this equation I am telling, if I keep the concentration of B as constant and if I change the concentration of A doubled, which means this I will say it is 2A, then experimentally, we are saying a hypothetical situation, experimentally we will get the rate of reaction, or we have seen the rate of reaction is getting doubled. Correct? Then I can say the rate of reaction is proportional to, listen, the concentration of A to the power 1. Listen very carefully, to the power 1. Why? I will say, if it is doubled, the rate is also doubled, which means the rate is proportional to A raised to 1. If A is doubled, it will become 2A. So the rate is doubled. Clear? Clear? Okay. So this is a concept, like if we are taking the concentration of B as constant, no change in B, and if you change the concentration of A doubled, experimentally you have got the R is doubled, then you can write r is proportional to a to the power 1. That means it is double 2a. 2a to the power 1 is 2b. Correct. Now for a situation is changing. If you are changing the concentration of b, see, if the concentration of b is doubled by keeping the concentration of a constant, then experimentally the rate of reaction, okay, it is not any theoretical, there is no equation, there is no theoretical explanation for that. Experimentally it is found that, say, the rate of reaction is 4 times greater. It is seen that, experimentally it is seen that the rate of reaction is 4 times greater. Then you can write R, that is the rate of reaction, is proportional to B to the power 2. Can I write this? See, how I will write this? That means if B is 2B, isn't it? 2B raised to the square is what? 4B. That is 4 times the concentration. See, so the R over or the rate of concentration is increased by 4 times. You got it? Then, so if you are getting this, then it will be easy. What I want to say is, or what I want to stick to is that this is an experimental quantity. Then if you are asking that if R of R can be half, yes. Experimentally, if you are taken R is doubled, there can be a situation where R of R or the rate of reaction is half. Okay, or if somebody asks me, if the rate of B is doubled, can the R of R will be 4 times lesser, 1 by 4 times, quarter time lesser? Yes, definitely. If the experiment shows like that, it is well. So there is no theoretical explanation for this. Whatever you get in the experiment, the rate of reaction is there. This is a simple example that I mentioned, just to get that concept. If sometimes, if I can say, if A is doubled or if A is kept constant, the rate of reaction may be doubled. Yes, it can happen because it is an experimental quantity. So, anything can happen. That means it only depends on the experiment. By experimentation, you can see how the rate of reaction for each of the reactants or products, we are not mentioning product here, each of the reactants goes. Clear? That is the situation. That is, experimentally, whatever is there, you can write for this equation, the rate is proportional to the concentration of A raised to 1 and into the concentration of B power 2. In this specific equation, we say, hypothetically we are saying, okay, if this is this, this is that. That's all. So, in that situation, I can write, R is proportional to the concentration of A to the power 1, because it is getting doubled, into the concentration of B to the power 2. That is, it is getting 4 times what? 4 times increasing. Okay, if there is no change in the ROR, I can write what? 0, because there is no change in ROR. So anything according to the experiment, you can change this power. That's it. Or I can say R is equal to a constant. If I remove the proportionality constant, if you remove the proportional, I have to give a constant. So that is equal to K into concentration of A raised to 1 into concentration of B raised to 2. So this is what is called as the rate law expression or rate law, where K is called as the rate constant. Do you get it? That is, this is nothing in connection, this power is nothing in connection with the stoichiometry of a balanced chemical equation. Clear? Or I will say, generally speaking, or in a generalized equation, I can say, if there is an equation A plus B, B giving C, C plus D, D. See, this is a general equation, you know. Correct? Now, what is the rate law for this equation? If I say, see, there are A and B are the reactants. This small a and small b are the stoichiometric coefficients. Now what I said the rate law is determined only and only by experiments and not in connection with this stoichiometry or something like that. For example, if you are thinking 2a plus b giving product, whatever it be, if I write the rate of reaction is equal to k into, can I write, if it is stoichiometric 2, can I write a raised to 2 and stoichiometric b is raised to 1? No. That is why I want to say this is not the case. It does not have any dependence on this stoichiometry. Okay, but accidentally or coincidentally stoichiometry can come. That we will study in the mechanism. Okay, so here if you take a general equation like a plus b, b giving c, c plus b, d, I can write experimentally, I can write the rate of reaction for A by keeping the B constant is proportional to the concentration of A to the power X. Generally. Correct? As well as the rate of reaction is proportional to B by keeping A constant, then B raised to Y. See? Like this I can write. Correct? Then I can write in both as R is equal to proportionality constant K into concentration of A raised to X and concentration of B raised to Y. So, this is the general rate law expression. That means, rate of a reaction is equal to rate constant, let's put a constant, rate constant into the concentration of A to the power X. This is an X. And concentration of B to the power Y. And here in the regular expression, definition itself it states that X and Y may or may not be the stoichiometric coefficient. It is given in the definition. That's why I am insisting that. This X and Y may or may not be what? The stoichiometric coefficient. May be the stoichiometric coefficient means it is incidentally coming as the what? Coming as the experimental thing. Okay, so that is, this is called as the rate law expression, where X is the power and Y is again the power. Okay, and this X and Y may or may not be the stoichiometric coefficient. But one thing I will say, you study like this has nothing in connection with stoichiometry unless experimentally or by chance, experimentally, if this got X is, X becomes A and Y becomes B, experimentally. You can write only A raised to the power A when this X is equal to A experimentally. For example, if it is 2, experimentally if it is 2, then it is okay. Correct? Only that case, incidentally it comes, only by experiment it will come. So, thereby the definition in general we can say, in a well-balanced chemical equation, the rate law determines what? Determines the concentration, the molar concentration. Why molar? Mole per liter. The molar concentration of each reactant raised to some power, that is X or Y, which may or may not be the stoichiometric coefficient. So that is why, that is how you define the rate law. So that is how you define the rate law. So rate law, the R of R, that is the rate of reaction is equal to the rate constant K into the concentration of A to the power X into the concentration of B to the power Y. Now we will define these terms. What is R? Rate of reaction. What is K? Rate constant. What is A? Concentration of A. What is X? It's a new term. What is X? You said that is not a stoichiometric coefficient. X is called, in kinetics, the X is called the power of the concentration of A or the power of the reactant with respect to A. Power. Okay. Order. Order of the reactant A. order. So X is the order of the reactant with respect to A, and what is Y? You can say Y is the order of reactant with respect to B. Clear? So you have got, what is K? K is the rate constant. What is A? Concentration of A. What is B? Concentration of B. What is X? X, there is a new term in kinetics that you call it as the order of the reaction with respect to A. And what is Y? Y is the order of the reaction with respect to B, the reactant to B. Clear? Now, how will you define an order of reaction? You can say X plus Y. You can also say X plus Y is equal to N, small n, where N is the total order of the reaction. The sum of the order of the reaction is N. So how will you define order of a reaction? Order of a reaction is what? The power of the reactants. Is it? The power of the reactants. The sum of the power of the reactant in a rate law expression is called the overall order of the reaction. Clear? That means, what is X? This is the order of the reaction with respect to A. This, what is Y? This is the order of the reaction with respect to B. What is the overall order of this reaction? That is X plus Y. And X plus Y, you call it as, or you give the name N for the total order of the reaction, or the overall order of the reaction. So how will you define an overall order of the reaction? It is the sum of the powers. Isn't it? Sometimes it is X plus Y plus Z plus so on. So it is all the sum of the powers of the concentration of the reactants, not the product, because we are dealing with reactants now. So it is the sum of the power of the concentration of the reactants, very important value point, in a rate law expression. Many students will cut out that in rate law expression. They won't write that. There the value point is there, they will lose half mark if it is 1 mark. They will only write what? It is the sum of the power of the concentration of the reactants, that's all. But very important, in a rate law expression, that also you have to write. Then only you will get the full mark. So now you know what is the order of reaction. It is the sum of the power of the concentration of the reactant in a rate law expression. Now tell me, what is the order of this reaction? You can write X plus Y, correct? Or if I say a reaction, see, rate is equal to concentration into, I mean, K into A raised to 2 into B raised to 1. Now what is the order of reaction? Sum it, 2 plus 1. What is it? It is a third order reaction. You will say it is a third order reaction. For example, again, R is equal to K into concentration of A raised to 1 into concentration of B raised to 3. What is the order? Fourth order reaction. Or the order of reaction is 4. If it is 0 and if it is 1, what will be the order? 1 plus 0, that is 1. And one more thing I want to say is, this order of a reaction which we represent it as X plus Y is equal to N. This N can have the value, or X or Y, the order can have the value, a positive integer, it can have positive values. It can also have negative values. Yes, it can also have negative values. It can also be 0, because it is independent of the concentration of reactants. See, here A raised to 0, which means it is having no dependence on this reactants. No, it is only dependent on B. That is why we put A raised to 0 is 1. Anything raised to 0 is 1. So, it is independent of this A. It is only dependent on B. So, the N or the X and Y can have the value of 0. Or even what? Even fraction. 1 by 2. If I say 1 by 2 and here it is 1. See, in this case, A raised to the power 1, that is first order, and here B is of the half order reaction. So what is the overall reaction? 1 plus 1 by 2, that is equal to 3 by 2. The order is 3 by 2. So that is why I said the order of reaction can have the values of plus positive, negative, zero and even fraction. So is it clear what is the order of reaction? Now what is the Rayleigh expression which is clear? What is Rayleigh expression or how it is defined? It is defined as what? It is defined as the dependence of the rate of reaction with the molar concentration of the reactants raised to some power x or y, which may or may not be the stoichiometric coefficient in a well-balanced chemical equation. Correct. So that is all about the rate law and the order of reaction. Okay. Let me make it some more clear by giving another example. Okay. This much is clear. Order is clear. Okay. Sum of the power of the concentration of the reactants in a rate law expression is called as the order of reaction. The order can be positive, negative, zero or even fraction. Okay. So this much is about the order of reaction. Okay, let me tell you one more example to make it more simple. Like in the case of a reaction like a CH3Cl plus HCl will give you Cl2 giving CCl4 plus HCl. Okay, only this much. See, in this experimentally it is proven that experiment, because it is not a theoretical thing at all. So experimentally it is proven that the rate of reaction or R is equal to the concentration of CH3Cl and the concentration of chlorine raised to half. See, is it the stoichiometry here? The stoichiometry here is 1 and 1. But see the rate of reaction, just to make it clear. Why? Here CH3Cl is raised to 1 and here the chlorine is raised to 2. Which what I want to mean to say is, this rate of, the rate law is only an experimental quantity. That's all. Okay. So, some examples are given in the textbook. So please go through the textbook. There is one example given in the textbook of NO2. Please refer to that. Any doubt, they are given the experimental quantity there. How the rate of reaction increases or decreases. And they are giving the rate equation there. So please go through it. And any doubt, please clarify with me. Till then, keep studying. Thank you.